Nothing broken?
A few scratches, but nothing serious. Blackfrost doesn't seem to appreciate our company.
Guess we chose a bad time. Looks like he already has some guests over.
And his concubine managed to separate us. We need to find the others.
Relmar, you got me?
Yes?
Do you know this place?
I've never been here, but I've heard about it. Before Blackfrost set himself up here, this was an ancient elven city, long abandoned.
Why is that?
It was a city dedicated to the arts and entertainment. Something about the architecture, or perhaps the place itself, seemed to augment the power of the work that artists here were able to do. The tale is told of a tragedy being performed here that was so powerful that all the spectators and the whole city just died. I'm serious. After that, no elf wanted to come back here. The place was thought to be cursed.
Let's change the subject. Let's move.
Like an ancient elven sewer, but it hasn't been used in centuries.
Prince Arundel.
We can't just leave him here like this. We have to take care of him.
You really think that now is the time to hold a funeral? We've been tripping over bodies for days.
I wasn't speaking of his body. We don't even practice ritual burial. But we must take care of his soul.
So now you take yourself for a priest?
Of course not. Don't you remember the Stone of Souls? Where each elf stores his memories, his feelings? Know that in the case of the kings and the princes, this stone is particularly important. It is unique and very ancient. It's all the memories of all the kings of the past in one jewel. We cannot simply leave it here. This stone has a crucial role for our people. And what's more, it contains immense power.
And you want to get it back?
Precisely. Without it, there will no longer be a king to reign over the elves. And who knows how it might be used if it were to fall in the wrong hands.
Plus, you might need it yourself, right? But meanwhile, we're pretty much stuck. There's no way to get to his body.
You're right. Find a way past.
There, you see? Already giving orders, Your Majesty.
Vulcan, I knew that you would find us.
Did you get separated? Where are the others?
Well, the attack of this concubine took us by surprise. The group was broken up, and unfortunately, not everyone managed to escape. We set up camp and did some reconnaissance.
What did you find out?
Not very much for the moment. This area is particularly hostile. There is a powerful, corrupting magic everywhere. It seems to strengthen the undead and weaken us. Nevertheless, Mathras seems to thrive in this strange atmosphere. He has been serving as our scout.
I've been sensing something unhealthy in the air. This field of corruption might cause us to slow down.
I can feel it too. It's not the nicest feeling I've ever had, but I don't think it's gonna slow us down much.
Speak for yourself.
My head feels like an anvil, and that's without my even listening to Randval say anything. If I have to continually fight against this evil magic, there's a good chance that I will start to slow you down.
I understand. Let's go and find Mathras. He might have found out something useful.
Hello, Vulcan.
Let me see what you've made this time. Can I do something?
No, thank you.
I'll be...
Greetings, mercenary.
Can I have a look at your stock? Got a minute?
Yes.
I have a few. Let's change them. I'll leave you.
down there. We're here. Come and help us. We can't hold on for too long.
This door is blocked from the other side.
Thank you.
Mathras, you're still alive.
Are you trying to be funny? Of course I am. Though I did nearly have to change bodies. So here we are, a little closer to our goal. Of course, the next thing we must do is to find a way to dispose of Blackfart's wives.
Blackfart's wives?
Are you shocked? Blackfrost's polygamy is probably a reflection of his megalomania, even though it was quite common in the past. The most powerful of them is called the Guardian. She is protecting the palace entry, and I fear she is invulnerable as long as her three sisters live. You must first face the Creator, the Stalker, and then the Watcher, if you are to have any chance of defeating her.
I've already beaten one of them. I can kill the others.
I don't doubt it. But this place is bathed in a kind of corruption that lends strength to these creatures.
Is there a way of getting rid of it?
Probably. There are still a few red scribes around. Stupid though they are, they may have some idea how to proceed. Did you know that before it became Blackfart's Folly, this place was originally a palace built by the elves, devoted entirely to theater and song?
I don't think that's gonna help me much.
Alas, what a dull world it has become. You know, the acoustics in there are quite wonderful. You should give it a listen while you're killing the concubines.
What do you know about these creatures?
Well, I don't know them as intimately as I'd like, but I believe they are women who were chosen for their diverse talents. And our fine Ice Lord decided to transform them. He calls them his concubines, and they serve him faithfully in every way. The dream of many men, I presume.
Mathras.
My dear.
I want to... Why are you still here?
Well, you see, my dear, my curiosity knows no bounds. And you already know I'm immortal. I should think those two reasons would be enough to allow me to be present for the end of the world, though obviously it is my dearest wish that your little plan should succeed. Your capacity to resist the intrusion in your body of an extraordinary spirit is absolutely fascinating. Know that if the world is not totally destroyed in the next few hours, but that you should fall, I will personally ensure that your story is remembered.
I don't know if I should thank you for that. This Blackfrost, have you ever met him before?
It's entirely possible. But if I did, he didn't go by that name in those days. You see, at that time, I found the company of any and all living creatures quite simply unbearable. I had decided to move to an area as far away from anyone else as possible. As the desert climate tends to wear out my bodies faster, I opted to move up to the Great Frozen North. I lived there peacefully in my modest palace for some years, until one day, a small group of people arrived. There were a dozen apprentice sorcerers who called themselves the White Lords. Believe me, in those days, Lord was about the last thing anyone would think of calling them. On reflection, I should have slain them on the spot for having disturbed my peace and stolen some books from my archives. But I was rather bored, and their thefts intrigued me, and so I followed them. I picked up their trail in a city a few towns along. There were quite a few of them at the time, and the locals seemed to like them well enough.
Are you talking about the Ice Lords?
Yes, of course. Though they weren't calling themselves that. I watched them for a while, but they were so ridiculous that I quickly grew bored of them. Clearly, managing to steal from my library had been the result of the merest stroke of luck.
And Blackfrost?
Doubtless he was one of them. A talentless conjurer who imagined himself a great mage without having any of the abilities to go with the title. Of course, with the passing of time and using my research, they finally managed to achieve their goal. If they're still the gang of megalomaniacs that they were, then they are extremely dangerous.
Did you know all along that Edwin was really the White Lady?
Yes, even though I almost didn't recognize her with all that clothing on. You may not believe it, but when she was a young girl amongst the White Lords, she liked to stroll around nearly naked.
How come you never said anything?
Oh, please. It would be a shame to spoil the delightful humor of such a situation.
Talk to you later.
I owe you my life, human. And more, actually.
Don't worry about it. It's been happening to everyone lately. There's a camp a bit of the way up. You should go there while the coast is clear.
Thank you. But there are still some prisoners over there. I can't just leave and act as if I don't know what's in store for them.
I'll see what I can do for them. Go back to the camp. The Red Scribes can take care of you.
Fantastic. Thanks again, soldier. Hope to see you at your camp.
Truth is, I kicked all the dead Morkers' asses weeks ago, but I need some time to work up the guts to let you out, knowing how you'd be bitching at me.
Good to see you, Vulcan. I was up the creek this time.
Didn't want to tarnish the legend. Don't stay here. There's a camp not far away, but you're starving.
I heard voices across the way there. Elves, I think. Also prisoners.
Don't worry about them. I took care of it. Did you see any of our guys around?
Yeah. There's one of those ugly women on four legs around. She got several of our guys. I was able to observe her a bit. Looks like she's avoiding those pillars that are around here. That may be something you can use if you feel like fighting her. And knowing you...
A concubine, huh? Yeah, I won't let her get away from me.
Good. More power.
Smoker.
I'm happy to see that you are still alive. I wish I could say the same for your companions.
Sybil? Ranval?
Neither they nor your mercenary comrades show any sign of life, which leads me to think, what horrible carnage.
I'll have to go look around the place in case one of them is still alive.
Even if there's only a slim chance, you shouldn't hesitate. Unfortunately, we've got something else on our minds. Mathras doubtless spoke to you about the strange corruption in this place. Corruption that makes the undead much more powerful, sometimes even unbeatable.
Do you know of a way to beat it back or wipe it out?
I believe I have an idea, yes. The corruption does not extend to all places in the same way. Some areas seem to be exempt. And I believe the undead I saw there were less comfortable. These are exactly the same places as where the crystals with magical capabilities can be found. If you can gather some, we will be able to make you a talisman that will let you drive back the corruption around you, and so fight the undead as you usually would.
And repulse the Deadwalkers?
I doubt that the lone talisman is powerful enough for that. Added to which, you have to stay completely still. But the idea...
When he looks like that, it means he's trying to think. Funny, isn't it? Here, I'll show you the zones where you can find the crystals on your map.
Excuse me, I was lost in thought. Here, take this to gather the crystals, and bring us back as many as possible. That's a pretty good idea. If we place the crystals around the camp, we should be able to keep the undead away from here. Of course, we'll need more than it takes to make a single talisman.
All right, I'll bring it back for you. Anitra. Have you seen the smith, Renko?
He was in the camp just a short time ago. But he was complaining about needing materials, I think. He was talking about going in the sewers to find them. The poor fellow must be dead by now.
Not exactly the smartest decision he ever made, is it? But maybe he just got lost. When I can, I'll go see if I can find him.
Have you found...
I'm working on it. I still need to... Let's change the... Can I do something?
No, thank you.
I'll be going.
I'd like to thank you again, Freeborn Blade. We were very lucky you were there for us.
Let's just hope we stay lucky a little while longer. We're far from out of trouble. Do you know this place?
Not very well. It used to be one of our cities, but nobody's been here for ages. Since then, Lord Blackfrost has occupied it in person. He's even apparently made it into his personal fief. But his magic has made the city unrecognizable. All of these profanations are an insult to the elves.
Did you spot Blackfrost?
Not in person, but he's not far. I heard one of his concubines talk about him. The one who looked like she had the most authority. The Lord of Frozen Shadows is aware of our presence, and the concubine gave his instructions to the others as a result. Most of their forces seem to be in the south. It'll take them several days to get here. This is your chance, Freeborn Blade.
See you later.
Captain, that concubine captured other Freeborn Blades too. Did you find them?
Not yet.
You want me to take care?
No, you're the only one I can trust to manage the camp while I'm away. I'll find our men. Do you have any news from the other Freeborn Blades?
Almost all of them are dead. I think I saw Hawk's body, but there wasn't enough left to be sure it was him.
Shit.
You said it.
Later. Relmar.
Yes?
I have... Let's change. I'll leave.
What an idiot. I could have stayed up there in peace and quiet, but no, I had to be cocky.
Be praised. You saved my life. Without you, those things would have ripped me to shreds a few yards from the way out.
There are quite a few nasty things in the sewers. We should go back up. What the hell were you doing in there on your own?
I needed supplies. And did you see the bodies? You just have to bend down to collect iron, leather, and even entire pieces of armor. Everything an honest blacksmith needs to keep a forge worthy of the name going.
Yeah, for the moment, looks like all you've been collecting is shit. We're going. This place is way too dangerous to just hang around and chat.
Without you, I'd be just one more body down there. Hello, Vulcan.
Let me see what you know.
Thank you.
Hello, Volk.
Really does stink.
Thank you. But I think that... I'm sorry. My time is near.
You're not dying here. Tell me what I can do.
I need medicine, a potion, a bandage, something. My strength is almost gone. I can't do it myself.
Here, I got what you need. That's gonna help.
Thank you, Vulcan.
Don't mention it. I was just passing by, you know. How the hell did you get yourself into this mess?
After you disappeared, I got separated from the other survivors. Three other scribes were with me, but we were attacked by one of the concubines. It was the Creator, one of Blackfrost's wives.
She let you go?
I wish she had. No. The other scribes threw themselves at her so I could escape. They gave their lives to save me. That God's damned piece of filth! I'm gonna make her pay!
I've never seen you this angry before. But there are other more urgent things first. We should leave here. Come with me. She's coming back with me. Wait for me back at the camp.
Come on! is a good thing for a glorious death. I can breathe his last with his blade and heart.
He's got his voice. Sounds like...
The knight thanks his friend for coming to his aid. He is surprised to find that he is happy to still be alive.
There was no way I was going to leave you like that. It would be best if you rest and get your strength back at the camp. It's over by the sewer outlets. Or should I say, White Lady? It's nice of you to come and see me. You left in such a rush.
Laugh while you can, you idiot. Your stupidity has condemned this world.
That's funny, coming from a fallen Ice Lady.
You had a chance to take Black Frost by surprise, a unique opportunity to thwart him, and you let it slip through your fingers.
What? You think I'm here to enjoy the scenery?
You are here because he wishes it so. He's waiting for you. You have given him time to prepare for you, to think of a way to get his hands on the power you hold. And there can be no question of letting him do as he wishes. For over a year, I have labored alone to liberate the World Heart. The power belongs to me and no one else.
Don't worry. I'm gonna give you more than you can take.
Short, but sweet.